It's the Not So Late Show.
Coming up,
Derek wears a hat. George looks cute. I look mighty serious. We laugh on Zoom. And Gareth talks into the distance. And much more on the Not So Late Show.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to the Not So Late Show. With a bit of a twist, due to obvious ongoing circumstances in the world, we're not able to be at the Riverhead Theatre. So instead, we decided to make an online episode entirely from our homes. But first, before we get on with today's show, I want to send a massive thank you to the NHS staff, emergency service workers, and of course, all the key workers out there, keeping this country running, and more importantly, keeping us safe. Thank you very much. We are forever in your debt. And now, let's get on with today's show. It's jam-packed with entertainment, with performances, sketches, and even a game show thrown in there. So let's get on with it. Up first, it's the George versus Ben challenges. Boys, how are we today?
Hello.
Good. Hello.
I'm nervous.
Nervous?
You should be.
Yeah. Let's get into the very first ever George versus Ben challenge. I'm going to give both of you a challenge. You are then going to have 24 hours to complete it to the best of your ability. Then after 24 hours, myself and some guest judges, this week that will be Molly and Erin, will then score you on how well we think you did. Now the winner gets the bragging rights. The loser has to do a forfeit. Now this week's forfeit, we have agreed, is an ice bucket over you. So boys, are you ready to find out what the challenge is?
Yep.
Yeah, about as ready as I'll ever be.
You boys are going to become TikTokers.
That's right. The very first George versus Ben challenge is TikTok. The viral app that replaced Vine is full of short-form videos from dances to lip-syncing to the downright bizarre. The challenge for the boys is simple. I'm going to give them four specific TikTok trends to create and a wild card. They have 24 hours. Whoever does the best, according to the judges, wins. Whoever loses gets very, very cold. Now, the TikTok trends are the Savage Challenge, classy, bougie, ratchet, sassy, moody. The I'm Just a Kid Challenge, when you're spending every day on your own, and here it goes, I'm just a kid and life is a nightmare. The It's a 22 Challenge, pew, pew, pew. Hold up, wait a minute, is a chopper. A voiceover challenge where the sound is up to them.
So a bit of village scandal. A mobile hairdresser has just gone down for 9 years for being a drug dealer. I mean, that's crazy. I've been going to her for God knows how long. I never knew she was a hairdresser.
And finally, the wild card is that they have to create their very own TikTok. Over to you, boys.
I've had a look at the videos. Most were all right. The Savage one's going to be embarrassing, but we'll do it anyway. I've got a few good ideas, though. I know what I'm going to do for the last one, where we can do it one.
So, on the Not So Late Show, we are having a George versus Ben challenge. Yes, yes. And we've been given 24 hours to complete this challenge by Phil. So, this week, or however long it is a TikTok challenge.
No.
So we have to do 5 TikToks, 4 of which Phil has already given us, and then 1 of our own, so we've got to be innovative.
First one I'm doing is It's a Chopper, and I decided just to dress up for the part instead of actually changing anything.
Stop. Need more films.
More films. There weren't any films there.
No!
Just on video two, the last minute one, it changed from boarding the house to just a voiceover one. I think I found that quite funny, I think, so that I'm hoping I win that one.
Really bend the bin, not me.
Right, I'm all dressed for the I'm just a kid video. Not quite the same, but I didn't have any striped shirts. Yep, hair's done now. No idea why I had that hair. I don't know what I was trying to look like then. Only a couple of hours to go now. Three videos still to record. Decided that instead of just changing what I actually do in them, if I change how I look in them and like have ridiculous costumes, maybe that will give me the edge over whatever Ben's done. As I said, ridiculous costumes. Right, I've still not posted the last video. I've recorded one, but I'm not 100% happy with it. But I think it's... Alexa, what time is it? Yeah, that'll have to be good enough. I've got 7 minutes.
We'll be right back with the George versus Ben challenge. And trust me, the videos are well worth waiting for. But first, we've got an amazing performance from one of our very own, Erin Ramsey. And she's duetting with, of course, the absolutely amazing Zach Lewis. Take it away, boys and girl.
So I got you a present. I went downtown to get it. Doing anything tonight?
Cleaning.
Done for the day.
No way.
Cause we got a date.
Okay.
Before you board that plane. I owe you a bottle of cold champagne.
No.
Yeah, cold champagne.
Damn, the bottles are sweaty and everything. You win and got this thing. I don't know if we have coffee cups or plastic cups. I think Sonny has the cups.
Tonight, we're drinking straight from the bottle. Oh, snappy.
Yeah.
Daniela told me what you did for me. And it's honestly the sweetest thing anyone ever did for me. Now, what can I say or do to possibly repay you for your kindness?
How do you get this gold shit off?
Oh, snappy!
Yeah!
Before we both leave town, before the corner changes and the signs are taken down, just walk around the neighborhood and say our goodbyes. Snappy, are you alright?
I'm fine, I'm trying to open this champagne. You see, the twisty thing is broken, but I'm gonna open this damn champagne.
Let me see.
No, I got it!
Oh, snappy, drop the champagne.
I mean, you went through all this trouble to get us a little bubbly.
And it's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry, it's been a long day.
You wanna stay?
What?
You can use that money to fix this place.
Haha, very funny.
And it's not like Sonny's got role models.
Role models? Yo, what are you talking about?
I'm just saying, I think your vacation can wait.
Vacation, Vanessa, you're leaving too.
I'm going down to West 4th Street, you can take me.
What are you trying to say?
You're leaving the country.
What are you trying to say?
Everyone gives you coffee, then off you go.
Vanessa, I don't know why you're mad at me.
I wish I was mad. I'm just too late.
Wasn't that just fantastic? Thank you very much, Erin, and of course, Zach, for being a guest on today's show. Now, let's get back to George versus Ben.
So, hello, boys. Again, we meet again.
Hello.
Lovely social platform. How are we doing?
All right, yeah. It's been a bad long day.
I'm shattered.
Yeah, I am as well, yeah.
So how did you find the experience of being TikTokers?
Well, it wasn't bad, but I won't want to do it again.
You're not going to carry on after this?
No, I'm deleting it.
Ben's over.
I don't know.
Did you enjoy it, though?
I enjoyed it, but, like, I don't know if I want... I don't think I'd carry on.
Okay. Are you happy with your results?
Yes.
As happy as I can be.
So, two things. I'm not dressed like this for the Not So Late show. I'm sorry. It deserves it, but I'm not. I'm dressed like this because uni shut down and everything's online and it's really sad. Secondly, I also can't believe I was made to download TikTok for this. I just had to spend 15 minutes waiting for it to download. 5 minutes going through the tutorial that I don't care about, but the worst bit about it is that I know in 3 days' time I'm going to be obsessed with TikTok.
Okay, so it is now time to look at the TikToks.
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a chopper. It's a chopper. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a 22. It's a chopper.
Hold up.
Wait a minute. It's a 22. Pew, pew, pew.
Oh, bless.
It's a 22. Pew, pew, pew.
Okay, I like that one. I like that one, Georgie boy.
Amelia is so cute.
Loving the Nerf gun.
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a chopper. It's a chopper. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a 22.
Okay, yeah. You boys embraced the TikTok spirit. I like that.
Ben is so sassy. He's like, it's a 22. He knows what he's doing.
Wait a minute. It's a 22.
I want to see these without the heads. I just think it's sassier without them.
Made so you back them. I'm a savage. Yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet. Yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty. Hey. Yeah. Hacking, stupid. What was happening? Whoa. Bitch, what was happening? Whoa. Bitch, I'm a savage. Yeah.
Okay, well done, Ben. You fully committed. I like it. Did get your sister to do most of the work, but I like it.
Why is he so good at it? It's the hips. The boy moves his hips. Couldn't tell you why.
Wow, Ben really gets his hips involved in that. Like Shakira, you are.
Made so you back them. I'm a savage. Yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet. Yeah. Sassy, moody, hey. Nasty. Hey. Yeah. What was happening? What was happening? I'm a savage. Yeah. What was happening? I'm a savage. Yeah.
Oh my god!
It didn't even faze me. It didn't, that's just really George.
I have many faces. Cute.
But he's my lover, so call me maybe.
Chill.
Damn, it feels good to be a gangster.
Sexy. And also funny.
But I feel like they will both become TikTok famous from this.
I'm sorry, I was not expecting George to do a slot drop.
sister.
Yeah, but she started it.
Say sorry.
I'm sorry.
Say it like you mean it.
I'm sorry.
No, say it like you mean it.
But I just did.
Say it like you mean it. I'm so sorry.
Oh my God, it's like I was watching my childhood. And I imagine he's gone through that a million times.
Okay, yeah, fairly relatable one, you know. Tea towel on your head gives a nice little smile off there.
When you're spending every day on your own, and here it goes. I'm just a kid, and life is a nightmare.
Oh, that one's just cute, because there's just more of them. Does that work? The more kids there are, the funnier it is. Yeah.
Aww. Aww. Ben's hair. Oh, he got a little afro going. That's so cute.
When you're spending every day on your own, and here it goes. I'm just a kid, and life is a night.
Apples. Oh, the worst bit is I know his mum. And I've seen his sister before. That's not weird. I'm just happy he got them involved.
George has got curtains.
I gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. I am the world turning inside out. Yeah, the floating around in ecstasy. Oh, so
don't stop me now.
Defying the laws of the gravity, and the risk of passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 go. The stuff in me, I'm born into the sky. Yeah. One of the crazy loves of all of Mr. Valentine. That's why. The-
Boys, you nailed it.
I will never get fed up with George doing that.
Right, the worst bit about that is that I genuinely can't tell whether that was improv or he'd sat there and made up the dance. It could be either.
I do not understand how people are not afraid of spiders. Like, it has 8 legs and like 20,000 eyes. I saw a spider in my room. You think I'm gonna sleep in there? And nope, I'm moving to Japan. Konnichiwa! Konnichiwa!
The suitcase.
Boys!
Voiced a very good job. Unfortunately, George has won, so sorry about that, Ben. Both hilarious though.
And there you have it. George wins, only just though. Ben coming in a very close second, but in a race of two people, second is ultimately the loser. Now, we haven't forgotten about the ice bucket forfeit. That will be coming later in the show because one of me, Erin, or Molly will be joining him. Now, let's go to the studio for a not so serious news update.
Good evening, and welcome to the Not So Serious News Update.
Good evening, and welcome to the Not So Serious Update. With another person.
Last month, the top supermarkets issued a list of scarce items, which included simple ingredients such as flour and eggs. While last week, the supermarkets announced that mixing bowls were now also scarce. One theory is that people are now at home in the lockdown, enjoying home baking. However, after nearly 2 months of this lockdown, it probably means that people have succumbed to using mixing bowls to help them perfect that 1990s bowl cut.
People have been spending their time in lockdown learning new skills. And if you want to learn some new skills, then I suggest you take a look at the Los Angeles Top 50 New Skills to Learn in Lockdown. Personal favourites are number 6, How to Train Your Cat to Use the Toilet, and of course, number 23, How to Make World Peace.
Timpsons have announced they plan to reopen several of their stores over the next few weeks. James Timpson, the chief executive, ensures that the 2-metre distance will be honoured. But many members of the public are querying whether Timpson's really does qualify as an everyday business. Mr. Timpson replied that his workforce are made up entirely of key workers.
In the United Kingdom, every Thursday, people have been coming out into the streets to show their support for the NHS, key workers, and in Scunthorpe, Mr. Boris Johnson.
What? Hey, you started it?
Yes.
Come on, Boris Johnson, you get better. Come on, you get out your doors, come on, let's clap for Boris Johnson. Hey, come on, Boris. Yeah, Labour. Oh, sorry. Go on, Boris Johnson. You're running the country. You love us. We know you can't make a magic wand, but go on, my son. Lucky them Labour not in. <It'll> be go on, Boris Johnson.
Inspiring stuff.
Bosses of Ryanair have announced that refunds could take up to 6 months to process, as the company has been forced to axe so many jobs. Who knew that by firing staff they could speed up the returns process?
Greggs' future remains uncertain as they announce they may not be able to reopen their stores due to fears of mass public gatherings in which they would not be able to exercise public distancing. Understandably, I mean, it would take a freak of science to be able to stand 2 metres apart whilst indulging in a sausage roll.
Taiwan is one of the few countries in which sport has not stopped due to coronavirus. In fact, they launched their baseball season just last month. But to make it feel a little more normal, they decided to source a rather alternative audience.
And that's all from me, Phil.
And from me, John. Thank you for watching.
And good night. Thank you very much, myself and John, giving a rather light-hearted take on the news. But up next, we have something that is very dear to this show. When we first created this show and did it at the Riverhead Theatre, we had original sketches created and they were performed on the show. Now in lockdown, you would think that'd be quite hard. But we called on one man. It's DJ Derek.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, mums and dads, brothers and sisters, boyfriends and girlfriends, and all of those who don't identify. Thank you for joining me from your homes. Not that you had much choice. I'm DJ Derek, and today we're going to be going through the top songs for you to enjoy in lockdown. First up on our list, reminding you all about that social distancing. It's the Police, but Don't Stand So Close to Me. Up next, a song for all those people that are locked down, all by themselves. It's, of course, the classic Celine Dion.
All by myself, don't wanna be all by myself anymore.
Okay, coming up now for all you shoppers out there, hoping you get a good haul. Let's hope you got all the right stuff.
You got the right stuff, baby. You're the reason why I sing this song.
And for all those mothers out there with no work tomorrow, sit back and have a few glasses of red, red wine.
Red, red wine goes to my
In all seriousness, this is a very scary time. You could say it's the end of the world as we know it.
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. And I feel fine.
Now, I want to speak to all those teenagers at home wasting away this precious time and say, right on, boys and girls. This one's for you.
I just wanna lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone, so leave a message at the tone. Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything.
Now, for all those besties out there dying for a catch up and a hug, my girl Vera has got a message for you.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
And speaking of hugs, remember social distancing.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
I also want to speak out to all those people having safe meetups at their windows and give you an anthem to sing along to.
Hello from the outside. At least I can say that I've tried.
Now, we are coming to the end of this list, and looking back and reflecting, it truly is a whole new world out there.
A whole new world. A new fantastic point of view.
And whilst right now you guys might be feeling a little bit lonely.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I have nobody for my own. I'm so lonely.
Just remember, we'll get through this, and then during the summer, we can all just,
come together!
But in summer. Now, it's social distancing. Anyways, that's been me. I'm DJ Derek, and I'll leave you with just one final message.
Derek!
Thank you very much!
Now, Derek is one of the Louth Playgoers, and if you want to find out what the rest of the Louth Playgoers have been up to during quarantine, go to the description, check out the link to their YouTube channel. They're posting vlogs, covers, all sorts of stuff. Go check them out. Now, though, we are coming to the most unorganized part of today's show. It's John's Random Game Show.
Finally found some charms, it's John's Random Game Show.
Hello everybody, so here we are with the first of hopefully many game shows. First of all, welcome to Phil Gives a Wave.
Hello.
Erin.
Hi.
Molly.
Hi.
Marvellous. And we're going to, I asked them to get together a piece of pen and paper. Shake your piece of paper, everybody.
I have a whiteboard.
Fine, that's not discriminate against that at all. And I also asked them to create some kind of noise as a buzzer, if you like. So we'll go the way around. Molly, your noise, please.
Oh, I couldn't find one, so I had to just get one offline, and I think it's a bit laggy, so.
Fine, very good. It's very Robot Wars-esque. Erin. Marvellous.
Love a good air horn.
And Phil.
I have a pig.
Very good. Excellent. Excellent. You're all through to the next round. Congratulations. Three questions. Now then, now in the first round, okay, I want no phones, no phones, nothing like that. No one in the corner whispering to your ear hole. Okay, okay. We're going to go round the group. Okay. And you're going to list one by one a pub in Louth.
Oh.
A pub in Louth.
Oh, actually, I could
discriminated as you run out. Okay, now, to decide on who gets to go first, okay, who is the youngest in the group?
Molly.
Molly, you're going Molly. To go first.
I've only been 18 for 9 months. This isn't fair.
Okay, we'll go to Eric and we'll go to Phil. So, okay, Molly, one pup.
The Woolpack.
Woolpack. Erin.
Joseph Morton.
Uh-huh. Phil.
White Swan.
Keep going.
Turk's Head.
Yeah.
Brown Cow.
Yeah.
The Consortium.
Oh, nice.
The Gas Lamp.
Nice.
Wheat Chief.
Nice.
My Father's Mustache.
Yeah. Oh, I'm out. I have no idea. I've only been to one of those.
There's at least like 8 more.
Are you out, Molly?
Yeah, that's I'm out.
Molly's out the first round. Keep going, Erin.
Cobbles.
The White Horse.
Greyhound.
Oh, jeez. Oliver's.
Ooh, nice one. King's Head.
Do we class the Masons?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Masons.
I've already said Wheat Chief.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've said that. Okay. Oh, now I've got to think.
I've got one. I've got two, mate.
Oh, Pack Horse.
Fun.
Pack Horse.
Oh yes.
TNC.
Course.
Town and Country Club.
Oh yes. Yeah. Sorry, Erin.
Does Panacea count?
Yeah, you can count Panacea.
Oui.
Fair enough.
The Cons Club.
Ooh, get you.
I can't believe you haven't mentioned one.
Boar's Head!
Yes! Thank you. So it's like you're local.
Nah, I think I'm out. It's the one near the co-op I'm thinking of.
I don't know, there was one near the car.
Oh, Miller's Daughter.
Yeah, that's what I'm at.
Erin, you win the first round. Congratulations. Okay, round two.
Round two.
Okay. This is where your noise is coming to play.
Okay, my noise.
I will not accept an answer unless you use your noise, no matter how clear you are with your item. Okay? I want you, in the confines of your room, you must find an object beginning with the letter D. Go.
G.
D. Phil.
The deodorant can.
Deodorant. Congratulations. Oh. Next item.
Oh God.
I'm scared now.
Must begin with the letter W. Phil's doing good. Next one. Okay. A letter beginning. No, an item.
I was going to say. Find a letter. Find a letter beginning with T.
Beginning with the letter P.
Pen. No, buzzer. Buzz.
Oh, well done. That's Molly's off the mark. Phil, you had a pig. I don't know why. Just a pig. Okay, keep going.
Oh dear.
This object needs to begin with the letter B.
B?
B?
Oh, Molly. Molly's doing it. Molly's on it.
I was staring at beer at the time as well. And it's Bud Light.
Okay, last one. Okay, Phil, you're on two. Molly, you're on two. Erin, you're still asleep. Okay, the object has to begin with the letter F.
Fan.
Congratulations.
Of course you had a fan.
Now the third round, okay, we're borrowing from Channel 4. We are going to do a round of countdown.
Yay!
I have created this smorgasbord of letters.
Okay.
Lots of letters, okay. Pens and paper at the ready. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on a flat surface. I'm going to look away. I'm going to move my pen around the page. And then each you're going to say stop. I'm going to pick out a letter. and then we're going to have 9 letters eventually, and that's what's going to make your, you know, make your words out of. So, well, Phil will have you to go first. Time to say stop.
Stop.
Okay, your first letter is E.
Don't say Q. You say
Y.
Q.
Oh, God.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right.
Yeah, 9 of the crappiest letters available.
Nine.
We've got a Scrabble dream.
I'm going to add, because obviously you didn't know whether they were consonants or whatever, vowels. I'm going to add, there's a special rule in that you are allowed to have one extra letter of your choice if you need to finish up your word. Well, you have 30 seconds starting now. Halfway through.
Shut
up. Started too early. Still going on. Finishing now. Bang. There. Stop.
I have 2 words that I'm not actually sure are words.
Okay. Bill, how many letters is your word?
They're both 6. But...
Bill's got 6. Erin?
3.
3. Ooh. Mole.
I have a 4 and 6, but the 4's in French, so that doesn't count.
Phil, what's your 6?
I don't know which one to go for.
Well, they're both 6, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, but I'm not sure if either of them are actually considered words.
Okay, then I've definitely won.
What are we going... what dictionary are we using?
My Ed.
The English one.
Okay. I'll go then with Zimmer. As in a Zimmer frame. Zimmer, because it's 2 yeah. words, isn't it?
Yeah, okay. So you've added an R. Very nice.
Yeah.
Well, what was your 6?
Monkey, and I added an N.
Aww.
Aww. Yeah, that's done.
My dyslexic brain was screaming.
That was very, very good.
Oh, yeah, what's Erin's word?
Gem.
My 3-letter word was key.
Oh, you could have just added an S.
Going to do an old-fashioned flip the pig.
Oh, brilliant game, John. I've actually played that on the channel. This is going to be uploaded. I'm
familiar with the rules of flip the pig. It works very much like flip a coin. Phil, you have the choice of belly or back.
Back.
Right.
It's got a lad on its leg, belly.
Oh, I've lost it now. It landed on its belly! It landed on its belly! It landed like that. So, Molly, you win. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Phil, I'm afraid you were bringing up the rear on this occasion.
Oh.
Which I believe, by your own admission and creation, that you are now subjected to doing an ice bucket challenge.
Maybe. That was it, and most of shambolic. It was John's random game show.
Yeah. Well, I guess I got what was coming to me for suggesting the ice bucket challenge in the first place. So yes, at the end of the show, I will join Ben in drenching myself in ice cold water. And speaking of the end of the show, that is actually coming up very, very shortly. So let's squeeze in one final performance. This man is Welsh, and he is a singer. Doesn't narrow it down much, does it? It's the one and only Gareth Bates.
Hello everyone, my name's Gareth. Thank you very much for having me on the show. It's an absolute pleasure to perform for you. I really hope you're all keeping safe, well, and busy during this time. Now, talking of keeping busy, I made it a mission for myself during this isolation period to go out and record some covers of songs that I both love and I've always listened to. Now, it's very important for me because I love music and I've always loved singing. And I was very lucky recently to have a song featured on BBC Radio Lincolnshire. So that is a song I'd like to perform for you now. I hope you all enjoy.
Thank you.
She can kill with her smile, she can wound with her eyes. She can ruin your faith with her casual lies. And she only reveals what she wants you to see. She hides like a child, but she's always a woman to me. She can lead you to love, she can take you or leave you. She can ask for the truth, but she'll never believe you. And she'll take what you give her as long as it's free. Yeah, she steals like a thief, but she's always a woman. She'll promise you more than the Garden of Eden. Then she'll carelessly cut you and laugh while you're bleeding. But she brings out the best and the worst you can be. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me. And she's suddenly cruel. She can do as she pleases, she's nobody's fool. But she can't be convicted, she's earned her degree. And the most she will do is throw shadows at you. But she's always a woman to me. Thank you very much.
What a performance, what a voice. Oh, the camera's over here. Sorry, Gareth. Thank you very much for that performance, Gareth, of that all-time classic Billy Joel number. If you guys liked what you heard and saw there, then do be sure to go into the description, check out Gareth's link to his YouTube channel. There's much more where that came from. Now, it is of course the sad time, where I have to announce it's the end of the show. But seriously, now it's time to end today's show. I've loved spending this time with you, and I hope you guys have too. And if you did like what you saw, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and comment down below and let us know if you want more. Because who knows, if you say you want some, we might just give it to you. Anyway, from me and all of the team, we'll see you later. And here's those ice bucket challenges.
Right, okay, so I lost, so here goes nothing, I guess. You can go. Thanks, I guess.
Got me.
jacket. Got me ice.
Oh. Whenever you're ready.